Tonight, three VIP titans decide the fate of our rising entrepreneurs, determined to prove their greatness in 60 seconds or less.
Holy shit, that was terrible.
There's only so many Shopify's of the world.
Can you break down where your revenue comes from?
I want to get vulnerable for a second.
That was a little greedy.
That's why we come do this show. That is unbelievable.
This is Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch, presented by Amazon Business, with support from State Farm and Canon. Meet our board of investors. Brad Woodgate, CEO of the No Sugar Company and Joyburst. Swan Sitt, Clubhouse royalty and executive advisor to global brands. Jacob Peters, angel investor and head of House Capital. First to enter the elevator is Gina Scorza and her holistic remedies for aches and pains.
Going up. Hello, Gina. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, my name is Gina Scorza, and I am the creator of Dope Minerals, a magnesium-infused skincare line. Magnesium is one of the most important minerals for our health, and using it through the skin is one of the best ways to get it into our bodies. Now, being deficient in magnesium can wreak havoc on our well-being. Migraines, anxiety, fibromyalgia, restless legs are just a few symptoms of being deficient in this critical mineral. I created this topical line of products to help people get magnesium into the body, and magnesium changed my life. I'm here asking for $200,000 in exchange for 10% to help even more people experience the magic of magnesium. I've sold over 15,000 jars of this cream, and I'm on a mission to let everybody know how important magnesium is for our health. So please join me on this mission to help people experience the magic of magnesium, especially through the skin. Thank you.
I've used magnesium for sleep for years, and I am actually a big proponent of magnesium, so I'm definitely interested to hear where she sold those 15,000 units.
Beauty's notoriously crowded and competitive. You have to have a ton of money to spend on acquiring consumers or getting into retail, and most people have no idea what it does. A little worried about that.
Attention, the boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been approved.
Yeah. Oh my God. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Oh my God, thank you, thank you, thank you so much.
Hey, Gina.
Hi.
Thank you, thank you.
Welcome to the boardroom, Gina.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you.
So Brad and I here, we're big believers in magnesium.
Yay.
But Swan, she wasn't so convinced. Oh. So only two of the three of us voted you into the room. So you have to sway the Swan here.
Okay. Well, I actually do have some sample packets if you are interested.
Yeah.
I can bring them up
let's
for you.
See it.
Sure, let's see it.
Let's see it. Quick question. So you've sold 15,000 jars of that cream. What's the price point for that and your other products?
So the magnesium cream is $29.99,
okay.
The 4 ounce. This is the magnesium one. Okay. This is magnesium and CBD. Ooh. Same thing. There you go.
Thank you.
The 4 ounce is retails for $29.99. I also have it in a 9 ounce jar that retails for $44.99.
So first off, when I look at your logo, which is called Dope Minerals, Magnesium Plus CBD, mm-hmm. I didn't hear you in your pitch mention CBD at all.
Mm-hmm.
I went through some mental health issues myself a few years ago, mm-hmm. and CBD actually helped with a wide range of issues along with magnesium.
Yep.
I do love it, and it does help me out on a very personal meaning and a personal effort.
I believe in the benefits because I use topical CBD and I've mm-hmm. taken magnesium supplements.
Yeah.
How are you gonna get this to blow up?
That's what I'm here for. That's what the money is. That's what the capital I'm asking for, is to help expand that marketing strategy in the direct-to-consumer space, doing more paid advertising, doing more digital media, doing more brand awareness, getting on board with influencers. My customers would have this shipped every month to them, so enrolling a subscription program would be phenomenal. They send it to their family members. It's incredible what this is.
So I can hear your passion. Yeah. It's so invigorating. What were some of those personal struggles that you really faced, and how did you come about that the dosages and the products that you made could really have that type of impact in your life?
So I was expecting my second daughter. Okay. And during the, you know, pregnancy wreaks, you know, havoc on your body. The cramping of my legs, right, was the worst, the restless legs.
Yep.
And I went to an acupuncturist to get relief with other issues I was experiencing.
Right.
And I told her about my legs. She said, oh, you need to use magnesium through the skin. And
okay.
I went home that night, I rubbed it on my legs, and that was the first time I ever slept. Yeah. I had slept through the whole slept through the whole night. And I was like, what is this magic stuff, right?
So it was a game changer for you.
It changed my
it
life.
Changed
but what
life.
I couldn't stand about the oil is it leaves a white chalky film.
Right.
It can be
right.
itchy. It's,
yeah.
it's a heavy salt concentrate,
right,
so it'll dry your skin out, hence the cream.
You had 15,000 units sold, mm-hmm, and the total revenue was what?
$450,000.
$450,000, and what was the profit margin on that?
The profit margin, my margins are 80%.
Well, so after your operational costs, after all your costs, what did you have left over to spend on other things?
I would say probably about, maybe 25%. You know, I'm doing.
I'm right here.
I know.
I want to invest. I'm so close. I'm really just to park this money. I'm just letting that natural energy go,
yeah,
your way. But you got to know these numbers.
I know.
You got to know these numbers. So your profit margin is?
I would say probably 40%.
40% of? The 450,000?
Yes.
So you're at like 200,000 in profit?
Oh, no, probably not. No, probably about 100,000 in profit.
100,000. Yeah. The numbers have kind of flown on me a little,
yeah,
bit, right?
The
you know, I'm a stickler for,
yeah,
numbers.
The numbers have kind of flown on me. So what is your projections for 2023?
Probably about 500,000.
500,000.
Yeah, with help.
With help.
Yes, yes,
okay,
yes.
All right, so Gina, sounds like you have the energy, you have the coachability, you've clearly got the product and the science and the personal story. I personally don't know this industry as well, so for that reason, I'm out.
Thank you.
Gina, I love your story. I love female entrepreneurs in beauty. Now, the tough thing is because I was in beauty for almost a decade, people think all I want to do is beauty investments. I love the space, but I also know how hard it is. I see how the sausage is made, and without a massive bankroll or some sort of spark moment that caught fire, it's just a really competitive industry. And for that reason, I'm out.
Thank you.
Me and you here. We're going to figure out if we have a deal. All right, so what I bring to the table is 75,000 retail doors just in North America. So the distribution that I can bring to this company would be tremendous. So I'm really trying to figure out, are you a person that I can see myself betting on that's going to work the 24 hours, 7 days a week, take on the stress and all the things that's necessary to make my investment a success? Do you think you have that?
Absolutely.
You do?
I've been doing this.
You've been doing
day
this?
Day in and day out.
Right.
You know, my exposure has been word of mouth. My growth has been very organic and just
okay.
going, doing shows as much as I could get out there
okay.
when I first started, yeah.
So for that, I'm gonna offer you $100,000 for a 10% stake.
I'll do it.
You'll do it? You don't need any time to think about it?
No, it's a deal.
All right, you got a deal. Let's go. All right.
Thank you so much.
No problem. All right.
I'm so grateful.
So
thank
happy
you
for you.
So much.
Amazing.
Congratulations.
All right.
Go, Gina.
You got a good one. You got a good one.
Yes! Thank you. I appreciate you so
thank
much.
Thank you for coming.
Oh my God. I'm so emotional. As you can see, this has been such a journey, up and down, roller coaster ride. So this was by far one of the most amazing experiences of my life. It'll change our lives. And with me and my daughters.
I'm
Absolutely.
So glad you did that.
Yeah.
That was amazing. She's amazing. I just don't know that space as much,
yeah.
but I wanted her to win, and you're the perfect person. I mean, these products have touched your life.
Yeah, they're a personal story to me. I said I could tell the emotion that she had was just phenomenal, and she had unbelievable heart.
Yeah.
What a great story. Love it. That's why we come do this show, is to have stories like that. That is unbelievable.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business for every organization at every stage of growth. Next, an entrepreneur proposes a future for quicker infrastructure that kickstarts project planning in minutes.
Going up. Hello, Johnny. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, my name is Johnny Magzal, and I'm a founding member at Togal.ai. At Togal, we are leveraging artificial intelligence to automate a task that currently takes construction estimators 2 to 3 days to finish, and we are reducing that to seconds. According to McKinsey, the construction industry is the least digitized in the world, and therefore it is very, very ripe for disruption. There are more than 900 contractors in the US, and our current product is sellable to 260,000 of them. We spun off out of the biggest construction company in Florida 3 years ago. However, we've only been in market for 10 months now, and we have 100 paying companies. Our average selling price is $3,000 per user per year, and we have 400 users on our platform. We have 2 issued patents and 8 pending ones, and we are looking for strategic partners who will help us on our growth journey. Thank you so much, and I hope to see you soon.
Wow, really interesting. What I love, I know nothing about construction, but I love solutions that fix outdated problems. Manual calculations being automated with AI, intriguing.
Yeah, I also love investing in industries where the software has a lot of green space. This is taking an industry that's literally doing things with pen and paper or manual labor and digitizing it.
When he talked about saying that there's something that he has that's ripe for a disruption in this industry of construction and making it more seamless or digitized, that to me is a lot of interest.
Well, let's vote.
Let's vote.
Attention, the boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been approved.
Yes, go Togal.
Go Togal.
Hey, how are you?
Hey,
I'm doing
welcome,
great.
Johnny.
How about you?
We're great.
Hi, Swan.
Thank you for your pitch.
So my name is Johnny. I come from Lebanon, Beirut, Lebanon. I worked in the construction industry for 7 years. Any estimator now, they spend 70% of the time clicking and coloring like they are in kindergarten, really. And these people spend 4 or 5 years in school. They don't want to do this. So this is the life before Togal. So this is a floor plan. Any typical, like if I sell carpet and somebody tells me, hey, how much carpet do I have in this building? I have to go to every point, like you see here, click, click. And this is only the corridor we are doing now, again. So a drawing like this would take like at least 40 minutes. We came up with this computer vision model that uses machine learning that with click of a button, instead of a person going clicking, it does all this drawing for them. And now the estimator, because there's so much art in estimating, now they put their knowledge. Instead of clicking for hours, now instead something that takes 40 minutes, it takes 5 seconds with Togal, let's say, and they put 2-3 minutes of their
right,
knowledge.
So you save the time mm-hmm. when the computer does the coloring in for
yes.
you. And then how accurate is that AI?
So in some types of outputs, we are more than 97% accurate. Mm-hmm. Again, our customers are so picky because there's so much money on the line. If somebody messes up one floor, that's billions of dollars.
Like, if you think a floor is a wall and you've got carpet on the wall, you've got problems.
100%.
Got it.
Yeah, exactly.
All right,
yeah,
Johnny,
exactly.
So this is a great tool that sounds like one pain point very well, right? You're taking a task
yes.
that takes 40 minutes or days, condensing it down to 2.
Yes.
But how does this become bigger than that? How does it become a platform where this is just one of many features in your software?
Thank you so much for the question, really. So we have 3 income streams. Direct to customer, which is Togal, which is $3,000 per user per year. We have the second income stream, which is partnerships. We have partnered with the biggest software companies in the US.
Got it. So how many users do you have today?
400 users.
400 users,
yes.
$3,000 a user,
yes.
$1.2 million in revenue.
Not that, because in the beginning, we had a lot of early adopters, and we did some enterprise deals, so we charged a little bit less because it's 70 users at the same same time. So we give them a little bit, a good discount for enterprises. But we have made between $950 to $1 million in revenue in these 10 months.
I did say no, because I didn't think I could add much value, but I know a good deal when I see one. On that $970,000, what's your take home? What's your profit? What's your EBITDA off that?
Currently now, we are in the process of gaining users, right? So we are building, that's why we need to partner with
people. So you're reinvesting the money back into the platform.
After we get the amount of users we want, it is 90% profit.
So right now though?
Right now, we don't have profit. No.
Okay.
No.
How big's your team? What's the leadership structure?
Yes, so the team is 11 people full-timers, and we have 17 people who are on like contractors.
Got it. But your role specifically is?
My role in Togal, so yeah. I'm a founding member with Togal, but my specific role is the head of product development.
As you guys knew from when we came on board, it was a no for me. Because I didn't think I could add value.
I just knew that.
So it's up to my fellow investors where their head's at.
Yeah, Johnny, this is amazing. You know, I like the category. I like the product. You know, honestly, if you told me you're the CEO, I'd believe you.
Thank you, but
I think the biggest question mark for me is just, can I add value as an investor? So something I need to know is, if we could wave a magic wand, you know, like, what is your biggest challenge right now? Like, what do you just need the most help with?
Yes, for sure. We know what our biggest challenge is. People from the industry, when they hear about Togal, like, people just want to throw money at it. What we are looking for more than money is people like you who help us target these customers. People who know how to help us grow companies, help us with our marketing strategy, sales strategy.
Remind me of the numbers again for this round.
For this round, in the safe will be $5 million. We are raising $5 million with a $50 million cap and 20% discount as well.
What you said, didn't he said, you're looking for people and expertise, right?
Yes.
So if I give you me, will you give me 50% of your company?
Would you like to invest in our safe?
Well, you said you don't need money.
No, you're looking for people. I actually did a big mistake.
These are two fine people over here to my right.
100%. 100%.
So I
take it back. I'm sorry. We didn't say we didn't need money. What I tried to say is that people in the industry want to throw money on companies like us. We're just trying to stay focused and hungry as much as we are.
Johnny, again, I like the category. I like you. But, you know, I just don't feel like I'm the right type of investor for this. So I'm sorry, but this one's not for me.
Thank you so much. No worries. Thank you so much. Please,
I like software that disrupts industries. I spent a decade helping consumer companies get into e-commerce, then get into social. So I love that about this business. It's changing things that are outdated. That said, this is my brand. I know nothing about construction, so I'm not going to be the most strategic partner, but I'm a really good problem solver. And I can help you guys think through not only how does this grow in construction, but how does this work across possibly other industries?
Yes, that's what we're looking for.
So I want to make a bet on you, but $50 million is really rich. So to make a bet, to start working together and see how we could build together, I would give you $50,000 on a $30 million cap.
$50,000 on a $30 million cap.
It kicks you off on this round. It gives you somebody who has an audience of a few million people to then maybe start getting different heads to think about, where could this technology go? Because I may not have the expertise in construction, but I think this technology applies far broader than just this industry.
Yes. Would you be open to like invest $250 instead of $50? I think that's a great deal.
You're asking for $250,000 when your revenues are under $1 million.
But we've been only in market for 10 months.
Well, if you're only in market for 10 months, then I should only give you $50,000 as a small bet right now. That is my final offer.
Final offer. Can I ask for a hug if we agree on that?
If we agree on it, you can have tens of hugs.
Thank you so much. Let's do that. Thank you. Let's do this. Thank you so much.
Yes.
Oh my God. Thank you.
Amazing.
Thank you so much. Great. Thanks, Brad. Yes. Thank you. Thank you. Nice to see you. Thank you.
Thanks, Jay.
Thank you so much. Should I do some salsa dance?
Wow, let's go, Swan.
I feel great. How can I feel better than that? We got Swan, she's perfect for us, and we're gonna do great stuff with her. Great stuff.
Wow. Great negotiation there. I love that. That was awesome.
The technology's good, he's amazing, but it's not an industry I have a ton of experience in, and it's so early.
Yeah.
Right? I know when technology can change an industry, it can be really exciting,
right.
But I've also seen some of them fail.
Right. Yep.
There's only so many Shopify's of the world.
Totally. Yeah,
you can't overpay.
Yeah.
Hey, Dad.
Hey, babe.
How are you?
I can't complain. It's all blessings.
Same here. I'm a little nervous.
Your mom already asked me, hey, have you heard from Zio? I said, I'm waiting for the cue. So.
Well, thank you so much. That means a lot to me. I know you guys are always with me in my heart and spirit, and I do this for you guys.
I'm absolutely sure your whole family is proud of you, your ancestors are proud of you, and the people that you support back home in Africa, Ethiopia. You know, starting with one person, now you're supporting 25 families because of your brand. That's, you know, I've never said that before, but that's what it is.
I love you so much, and thank you for your support. And I'll give you a call after we're all done.
Carpe diem.
Love you, Daddy.
Bye. Love you.
Next is an entrepreneur who prioritizes ethics in producing her leather accessories.
Going up. Hello, Ziomara. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, my name is Ziomara and I'm the co-founder and owner of UnoETH. UnoETH, meaning One Ethiopia, is a father-daughter leather goods brand based in Oakland, California. We design leather bags and accessories and partner with artisans in Ethiopia to craft them by hand. With backgrounds in merchandising, marketing, and international relations, we've grown our business year over year from 30 to 100% each year, barely keeping up with demand. We've been featured in a number of publications, and you might have seen us on the hit show HBO on Insecure. From pop-ups to being sold in stores nationwide, landing corporate partnerships, and growing our online sales channel, we're hungry for more. While laying the foundation, we learned that this is more than just about selling bags. This is about creating opportunities for artisans all over the globe. So today we're seeking a... Holy shit, that was terrible.
Hey guys, I mean...
Holy shit, that was terrible.
That was a certainly nervous pitcher.
The pitch was rough. So if we were to put that aside and give that a buy, I love the story behind it. I love the father-daughter duo, but these products are just really hard.
That product, from my perspective, has huge potential in terms of telling that story. So if you get that on QVC and she comes on, obviously her pitch would need to be buttoned up.
Well, what's also tough is I didn't hear anything about their sales so far. So I have no idea if this is concept or pretty established.
She said 30% to 100%.
But we don't know what the volume
is.
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's a little tough for me to gauge.
Yeah.
So we don't have as much information. Pitch was a little rough, but so much potential.
Attention. The boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been denied.
I'm definitely a bit disappointed in myself and my pitch. I've practiced it so many times and killed it in the morning all the time. The nerves definitely got the best of me, but I think this is just part of the entrepreneurship road where you just take your loss and keep going.
You know, I think you guys may have passed up a good opportunity. I respect your guys' decision, but ultimately I would have loved to have heard more.
But at the end of the day, this is not a tech product that sells itself. This is
right.
A brand with a story.
Right.
So I would be investing in the storyteller, and I just didn't see it today.
Next up, a digital platform makes investing as easy as pressing a button.
Going up. Hello, Chris. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, my name is Chris, and I'm the co-founder of Autopilot, where we are reimagining the way you invest your money. Autopilot is a unique investing app that allows you to automatically copy trade world-class investors, from hedge fund managers to financial influencers to even our beloved politicians, most notably the stock-picking queen, Nancy Pelosi. The app currently is in a private beta where we have over 450 clients, 2 million in AUM, and over 10,000 app pre-orders in just 2 weeks. We also have a robust social media presence with over 700,000 followers across 7 different distribution channels. Today, we're looking to raise $200,000 via a safe on top of the $3.5 million we've raised to date. And with that money, we plan to expedite the launch by hiring a world-class engineer and signing exclusive partnerships with key finance influencers. If you've ever dreamed of investing like Warren Buffett and Nancy Pelosi, open up these doors and let me turn that dream into a reality. Thanks.
I used to work on Wall Street and, you know, I founded a $500 million software company, so I love apps like this.
The only thing that kind of didn't make any sense to me, he's asking for $200,000 from us. It seems like a really low investment. And at the end of the day, what do you need us for $200,000?
And what did he spend the $3.5 million on?
Are you guys ready to vote?
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Attention, the boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been approved.
Chris.
Welcome.
How are we doing, guys? Thank you for having me.
So the first big question that is on all of our minds, you've raised $3.5 million.
Yep.
You're asking for $200,000.
Yep.
What do you actually want such a small amount for?
One, it's to capture, you know, the attention of you guys, figure out who strategically here can help us kind of expand and grow from there. But with regards to the actual money, what that $200,000 will do is it'll allow us to expedite the launch a lot faster than we originally anticipate. And with the early success that we've seen after just 2 weeks, we're like, why wait longer? Let's just do it now.
So Chris, you raised $3.5 million. How much is left in the bank and what have you spent it on?
So we have around $1.8 million left, and a lot of the money has gone towards salaries.
So you spent half the money and you only have 45 users?
No, we have 450.
450.
450 paying clients. We have wait lists that total in the 15 to 20,000, and then we just launched the app on a pre-order through this cool little thing that Apple does that got us 10,000 downloads in 2 weeks.
How much are they paying?
Most people are paying right now is $30 a quarter. We've made around 40,000, 45,000 to date in just pure volume.
I am not understanding how this opportunity makes money. Like, I loved your pitch. When you came up there, I was like, total thumbs up. I'm like, this is something I want to invest in. So I was really interested, but in 30 seconds, I need to be very clear. Can you break down where your revenue comes from?
We are about to witness the greatest wealth transfer in the history. $18 trillion about to transfer from Gen X to Millennials, Gen Z, and over.
So I'm transferring my money to Jacob. Go on.
Yeah. Okay. Jacob is sitting there with $500,000, $250,000 in Robinhood. He's like, I don't know where to invest. I don't know how to do it. I don't want to use a financial advisor. I don't want to put it in a SPY. I want to have this money actually invested for me.
Okay.
He goes to Autopilot and says, oh my goodness, I can go to this platform, simply connect my broker where my money already is,
26, 27,
where the money is already in it, and I can choose a world-class investor to literally have them manage my money for me.
Okay.
I can transparently see it, I can keep control of all my money, and
Chris, I really like you. I think this idea might have bones. There's a need in the marketplace for people to figure out how to responsibly manage their money. But in this whole conversation, I still don't know how you make money.
Yeah.
I heard 30 bucks for a quarter, but nothing else. And this is not also my field of expertise, and for that reason, I'm out.
So Chris, how exactly do you make money?
So we make money the same way that an Uber or a Patreon
okay,
would make money.
Gotcha.
Revenue share model based on the pilots that we have. And that's the other beauty.
So you make money when the customers make money?
No, we make money when the pilots make money.
When the pilots make money.
So the pilot, if you're really good and you're on Twitter, you got 30,000 followers, and it's like, I got 30,000 people.
Okay, so you're connecting pilots, which are big name people who are open sourcing their investment portfolios with investors.
Yes.
I have built apps myself. I'm not a techie, but I understand the space. I understand cybersecurity, I understand users, I understand what the need is for apps in terms of to elevate where he was trying to go. I don't think I can add any value to that from what he's presented to me today. So it's a no for me.
I like the market, you know, I like what you guys are building. I think it's interesting, but you know, it's a little bit high risk. So what I could be willing to do is I'd be willing to give you $50,000 with a 10% rev share on, you know, your first subscription income that
10%.
Comes in until I get my money back.
10%.
And then we can cut off
Isn't like 10% going to handcuff him?
We want to make sure, though, that every dollar we make is going right back into the business just to scale it. When we say we have 10,000, think about this, we have 10,000 pre-orders on the App Store in 2 weeks. We have 200,000 emails of waitlisting people that we are going to get on the App Store pre-order downloads. Once we launch in 6 months, 2 months, 3 months, we hit number one in the App Store.
All right, Chris, I don't want to hear any more details.
I appreciate
the
offer.
I'll bring my whole network. We'll get down and dirty. We'll do whiteboarding sessions, order pizza, stay up late for a week straight.
We're looking for the network, but we are not looking to have some of our revenue depleted from our future growth. Once we launch this thing, we can get 20,000 paying users in 1 week, and the valuation goes from, you know, 20 million to 100 million in 2 days. We already have venture capital.
I hear a lot of what ifs here. You know, you're kind of shaking my confidence. You know, I think I'm gonna have to roll with Swan and Brad on this one. I'm out, but I wish you all the best. I'm a believer in you, I'm a believer in the company, but we're just not gonna be able to get a deal today.
I appreciate it. And if you see us on social media, you'll see our community, you'll be like, ah.
Well. You know, Chris, one last thing, here's what I'll do. I'll put that 50 grand and I'll invest it on your app. How about that?
Ah, say no more.
Yeah. That's huge.
Yeah, we'll take it. We'll give you the friends and family discount then.
Wow, amazing.
I think with the minute pitch, it's very easy and very simple to know what you're gonna say and know how to pitch it. But once you get into that longer conversation, it's like, what do we truly do? What is the one thing we're trying to accomplish? And what's the one value we're trying to make sure that they know? Could have done better with that, but you know, we're getting better, we'll learn.
I've been in the past year in the trenches with over 650 entrepreneurs. I run a startup accelerator. The right entrepreneurs don't leave a stone unturned. So, you know, he shook my confidence a little bit with some of his answers.
Entrepreneur Elevator Pitch is presented by Amazon Business for every organization at every stage of growth. Our final entrepreneur has a fresh take on oat milk, which delivers better nutrition for all.
Going up. Hello, Betty. Welcome to the elevator. Your 60 seconds begins in 3, 2, 1.
Hi, I'm Betty, and I'm the founder of Upright, a consumer goods company on a mission to make delicious foods that are better for people and our planet. Our first product is a high-protein instant oat milk that's just as nutritious as dairy, but without the unwanted allergens or environmental impacts. I started this because I'm personally lactose intolerant, like two-thirds of all people, and I care about our environment, meaning that I don't feel good drinking dairy. Plant-based alternatives do exist, but most aren't great for the environment either, and they tend to lack a key nutrient, protein. That's why I created Upright's high-protein instant oat milk. Just add water for 8 grams of creamy, sustainable oat protein, whether you're at home or on the go. We're looking to raise $100,000 in the form of a safe. So if you're interested, I'd love to chat. Thanks.
That one caught me by surprise. I was waiting for the 100 grand for a valuation, but that's confusing. It's hard to even get a sense whether you want to invest in something that you don't even know what the value is.
Yeah, I'm not even sure if she's launched yet. Does she have sales?
Yeah, that's a good question.
That said, oat milk is a big trend. She's right, there's a lot of lactose intolerant consumers out there. And I'm really curious that a packet mixed with water can actually have good mixing viscosity so you don't get like chunky chalkiness.
Yeah.
If she's nailed that, that could be a product killer.
Attention, the boardroom has come to a decision. Your pitch has been approved.
Oh my God!
Betty!
Hello!
Hey.
Thanks so much for bringing me in here.
Welcome.
I'd love to tell you more about what I'm creating. I think a demo is probably in order.
Yes,
we're so
absolutely.
Ready.
Yeah, we're so ready for a demo.
I see a shaker, I see a frother.
My taste buds are tingling.
All you have to do, super easy, open the sachet. Most people can do that. You're gonna take your glass, or you could use a blender bottle as well, just dump it all in there. You're gonna add a cup of water, and I have a measuring cup over here. So we're gonna add a cup of water.
While you're showing how easy this is, do you have off the top of your head what the ingredients are that we're talking about?
Yeah, it's pretty easy, thankfully, to remember. So it's just oats and a blend of vitamins and minerals, and then for the vanilla and chocolate, we have vanilla and chocolate, right, and then stevia and monk fruit to sweeten it.
Good start.
Yeah. Good start.
So you've got your water, you've got the powder in there, you're gonna take an electric whisk, just pop it in there. You could easily use a spoon or like a fork, whatever you've got on hand. I find the electric whisk is just, it's a little faster and you can get that like little bit of foaminess on the top, which is
okay.
Nice.
Yeah.
But you know, there's lots of different ways to do it.
It's all right, I call for a sample.
You have some excited investors here because I think we're all interested in alternates to dairy, but that are also better for you.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, 2/3 of people are lactose intolerant, so it's a really common issue.
So we just sit with bad gut all the time.
Pretty much, yeah.
All right.
So here's a sample of the vanilla version.
Wait.
Cheers to upright.
All right, let's get to the exciting part. I'll start off, what are the sales?
We just launched in May of this year, so just a few months ago. So far, we've shipped almost 2,000 orders and about 5,000 units of product so far.
And how much do you sell each unit for?
Each unit sells for $15.
Got it. And how much do you make per unit?
Right now, because we are producing at a relatively small scale, we just launched, we are making about 25% margins on that.
The oat milk category is extremely crowded space. The only way you can get out of that crowded space is doing breakthrough marketing. So I'm not sure if you're familiar, I launched a product called Joy Burst, which is in the energy category, which is dominated by Red Bull and dominated by Monster. So they said, hey Brad, what can you do differently to stick out? So I came up with this thing called the Joy Walk. So you kind of go like this, and we went on national television and we did the Joy Walk. So I'm thinking, you think we can actually market an oat walk?
I would love to market an oat walk.
I think an oat walk could be something that we could market.
100%. Yeah, we're a young, really flexible company and really excited to do these, you know, kind of different sort of marketing plays, I guess.
That's amazing. So your ask is for $100,000 for a safe.
Correct. Okay. That's right. More money, the better. But okay.
And how much money have you raised so far?
About $500,000.
Got it. So you've given up 10% of the company to date.
Depending on what we actually raise that in the future. Yeah.
So we all want to know, you came on asking for $100,000 for what?
I'm raising a safe right now, and so that'll depend on the future valuation of the company based on an institutional round, but I have raised money in the past at a $5 million target valuation.
So you're saying right now you don't know yourself what the proper valuation is. Obviously, that would mean we don't know what the proper valuation is. So that $100,000 going out of our pockets is kind of still not clean to me. So what I'm trying to think is whether or not you'd be open to a specific amount of money between $50,000 and $100,000 for equity in your business. Is that something you'd be interested in doing?
At that valuation, I don't think I'd be comfortable taking that deal.
That was a little greedy.
If you're going to help bring this to 75,000 doors across the US, you gotta figure out, you know, how much are you bringing to the table outside of just the cash infusion, and how much is the cash infusion going to help grow the company?
Okay, so your margins right now are about 25%, right? Like, if you put this thing into stores, that's gonna further suppress the margins because you're not gonna be able to sell them to the stores as much when you go retail. I feel like this is the type of thing that would go viral completely organically if you had the right strategy.
We're trying to, yeah. So we actually have a bunch of creator, like influencer partnerships in the works right now that we've gifted them some free product. We actually haven't even paid them. And we're kind of waiting on the content that they'll come back with to share to their followers.
So I'll give you $100,000 for 10% of the company. It will blow this thing up on TikTok, get you a million followers in 6 months.
How about $200,000 for 10%?
So here's something I got for you. We're fortunate to have over 30 different products in Walmart and over 15 different products in Costco. So I'm willing to bring that to the table. I'm willing to offer $100,000 for 20% of the company on the basis that we get one of your SKUs into national listing in Walmart or Costco within the 6 months of our partnership.
I really appreciate that offer. I've actually already been in contact with Walmart and Sam's Club.
And what did they say?
Right now, the margins aren't quite there because I'm so early stage, but once we are at that level, that they were really excited to bring me on.
Exactly, so you have to know the game that you're playing here, Betty, which is you want to build a subscription revenue business where you can sell these things direct to consumer, shipping from a website, right, every single month, continuously. Like, that's not gonna happen if you try to get this thing into the big box.
There's 546 Costcos. They order by the pallet. From the sounds of what she just said, two clubs out of 546 would take on as much as she sold in lifetime in just two orders.
But then she has to compete, you know, with all due respect, with the Oatleys of the world.
But at the end of the day, consumers know where products are at, whether they're online, on Amazon, or in retail. Everybody is aware of where products are going to be. You're always competing. You're always competing against who has the best product. I think I can bring a lot of distribution to this game, but at the end of the day, I'm only investing in something that I have no equity when I walk out of this door.
Betty. I have an offer for you.
Sure, let's hear it.
So in addition to creating content or my time at Nike and Revlon, I'm also an operating partner at AF Ventures. So I bring an entire operating team that is used to the future of food and bev and selling into the retailers. So what I will give you now is $50,000 for 5%, but I bring an entire team of skills bringing this type of product into retail and D2C.
Before you answer that, just remember, again, the entire oat milk industry is built off of retail.
Actually, my thesis is that, like, the market's way bigger, it's just untapped, and it's waiting for a player like Upright to come in, you know, with a great direct-to-consumer subscription model and really blow it out of the water.
So I think you have three separate offers. Which of those three offers sound the most enticing to you?
Whew. I think they all have their merits. Oh boy. So Brad, I mean, I super value your food and beverage health and wellness experience. I'm not comfortable with the valuation, and I'm wondering if you'd be willing to move on that.
Because you're such a passionate, aspiring entrepreneur, I love your story. So I am willing to change my offer, but it's still going to be at an equity share of about 15%. So if you can live with 15% for 100 grand, on the basis that you get national distribution in Walmart or Costco within 6 months, I can make that offer happen.
Okay, thank you.
RVC has dozens of products, half of which is sold in the retailers you're talking about. Different perspective, but also value retail.
So Betty, I wanna get vulnerable for a second and let you know that I have Crohn's disease, which is an autoimmune disorder. I'm actually missing 60% of my digestive tract. So I have to be very conscious about every single ingredient that goes into my body. You know, on a personal level, in addition to the capital and the time, would love to be a part of this.
This is really difficult.
Betty, make a decision.
Oh my gosh, this is really difficult. Brad, are you?
All right, let's do it.
Let's do it.
Nice, come, bring it in. Can I at least teach you a little bit of that oat walk to go? Can you give me a little bit of this? It's just a little, this like that. There we go.
I want to learn.
There we go.
Let's
get this in here. Joy walk.
The fact that they all were genuinely interested and put real offers on the table was just, it was such an exciting moment for me. So I'm just kind of processing everything right now still.
So Betty, wait, don't leave yet.
Betty, we got some amazing, great news for you. So Amazon Business would like to put forth $10,000 as a prize to help you grow your business even further.
My goodness, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. That will help a lot.
Bravo, Betty, $10,000 cash.
$10,000. Yeah. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. I'm so excited. I cannot express how excited I am because I think I'm just still processing everything.
She's almost got it. She's almost got a few more TikToks.
Yeah,
a few more videos for TikTok. I mean, that thing will be viral. Viral!
With three entrepreneurs securing high-flying deals with our investors, two were sent back down to the bottom floor with nothing to show. Whether it's a new invention or a new way of living life, anyone could be 60 seconds away from rising to greatness or fall from glory. Tune in next week as our final six entrepreneurs enter the elevator
You're going down a false path.
I couldn't be happier. My dad is gonna wanna meet you.
I'm willing to give you the $3 million.
And to apply for the next season, go to entrepreneur.com/elevator pitch. Investors personally styled by celebrity stylist Kim Bolafay.